So making her way toward the boxing ring, wearing red and sporting a green bandana, is the reigning World Championship gold medalist, the number one seed in a women's middleweight division. It is Great Britain's Savannah Marshall, granted a bye by virtue of that number one seeding. So taking part in the Olympic tournament for the very first time. And her opponent from Kazakhstan, wearing blue, is the muscular figure of Marina Volnova, who produced a really impressive display in her opening bout yesterday to book her place here in the last eight.
Well, one, I remember Savannah Marshall coming onto the very first England training camp. And after the first day on this camp, the England coach, Mick Gannon, said, this girl is going to be one world champion one day. And wasn't he proved right? Our first ever British female world champion, Savannah Marshall, steps into the ring on this Olympic stage.
Introducing in the red corner, representing Great Britain, the reigning world champion of the world, it's Savannah Marshall. And in the blue corner, representing Kazakhstan, Marina Volnova. Second out. Round one.
The opening bell sounds in this women's 75 kilogram middleweight bout between the reigning champion of the world championship gold medalist from China in May, wearing red, representing Great Britain, and that is Savannah Marshall. Her opponent, wearing blue, representing Kazakhstan, is Marina Volnova. And this is her second bout here at London 2012, having prevailed in her opening encounter by a really impressive 20 points to 11 display over Elizabeth and Diego of Kenya. So Savannah Marshall, who earned the accolade of World Championship gold medalist to become Great Britain's first ever world champion in the Women's Amateur Boxing Championships history, making her Olympic debut before a home crowd. What a moment it is for her.
Marshall just needs to relax here. You can see in her shoulders that she's a little bit tense. How easy is it for me, Ron, to sit here and say to relax on the Olympic stage? But she is a very relaxed boxer normally. She'll get into the swing of things, but Volnova here is making it difficult for her.
Marshall began boxing at the age of 12. Just saw a friend doing it and thought, as kids often do, well, I can do that. Started boxing up in a club in Hartlepool, where of course Amanda Coulson was such a trailblazer for all of Britain's women amateur boxers. And Marshall lists her as one of the boxers she tremendously admires. And she secured that first ever world title on the day she turned 21. What a way to celebrate the 21st birthday by being crowned Great Britain's first ever world champion. She's involved, as you'd expect in the Olympic tournament, in a competitive opening round here.
I don't think there's much in this, Ron.
As the bell sounds, it couldn't be more accurate because it is tied at 4 points apiece. Let's listen to the instructions.
Deep breaths. You'll get a jab working.
Yeah, Dave Alloway there, the Great Britain coach, just telling Marshall to get that jab working. It's one of her best assets, long, straight, strong jab, but she's not using it to good effect. Well, she didn't use it to good effect in that opening round. It's just settling into this bout and to this amazing Olympic stage.
Seen some boxers who have been all smiles en route to the boxing ring. That was in stark contrast to Savannah Marshall. So as the second round begins, this contest in the 75 kilogram middleweight division is tied at 4 points apiece. and he features the number one seed who just got through the beautiful right cross, wearing red, representing Great Britain, Savannah Marshall, the reigning world champion, and her opponent is from Kazakhstan, Marina Volnova, engaging in her second bout here at London 2012. And you heard the coach, Dave Alloway, say to do just that. He used that jab to good effect to try and exploit that advantage in height and reach that she possesses.
Yeah, absolutely. Dave was saying just don't get too involved. You don't need to. You're the taller boxer. Keep it at range. Use that jab and tee your opponent up for the backhand, which, quite frankly, would take anybody's head off, boy or girl in the ring.
Got herself a bronze medal at the European Championships last year, did Savannah Marshall. So despite her tender years, she really is racking up international experience and international hardware. How she would love to repeat that here on the grandest stage of all, the inaugural Women's Olympic Boxing Tournament. And both of these boxers are one win away from a guaranteed place on the Olympic podium.
Good 1-2 combination there by Savannah on the second phase. Covering up nicely inside, but she doesn't need to be there. As Dave said, her coach doesn't need to be inside, keep it long. A backhand lands there. Exactly what she needs to do as Volnova comes.
Referee allowing the boxers to work away on the inside. Marshall disengages, gets it back to punching range, but then it's at close quarters once more. Inside the final 30 seconds of this second round, remember it's scheduled for 4-2s, and that was a beautiful right cross out of the orthodox stance landed by Marshall.
Marshall dubbed the silent assassin by the media recently. Very painfully shy in front of the camera, in front of any media. But she says, quietly, in her own way, my boxing does the talking for me.
And it speaks volumes given the international success she is accruing in tournaments around the world. Most notably and indeed significantly, Britain's first ever world champion in China in May. Good left jab, snaked out just before the bell. And perhaps that brought it back to parity for Marshall, because the score remains tied. It was 4 points apiece. Now it's tied at 7. Let's listen in.
You cannot fall in on that. It all gets messy then, doesn't it? Close your eyes. You cannot fall in. You've got to get a judgment of the distance power. Okay? Well done. Deep breaths.
Yeah, as we see there, it was a better round by Marshall. She got caught with a few shots there by Volnova. And as Dave Alloway, her coach, is saying, you've got to keep it long. You cannot afford to fall in with the shots, because you're giving Volnova the opportunity to score back. But Volnova putting up a spirited performance here and really matching Marshall punch for punch at the moment.
We've completed two rounds. We have two more to go in this women's 75-kilogram middleweight contest between Great Britain's Savannah Marshall, the number one seed in the tournament, making her Olympic debut, against Kazakhstan's Marina Volnova. Both of these boxers part of large boxing teams, as Marshall just disengaged and landed with a short arcing right hand at close quarters. But it's an 11-strong boxing team for Kazakhstan, comprised of 2 women and 9 men. Whereas Great Britain are one of 3 countries to have women boxers represented in each of the 3 weight classes being contested, along with 7 men as well. The men have been dubbed the Magnificent Seven, and they comprise to form a 10-strong Great Britain boxing team.
Yep, Volnova, great tactics here, I have to say. She's spoiling Marshall. Marshall's trying to work at range, but Volnova's working very hard to get inside and to spoil Savannah's combinations in her boxing. Just holding on there on the inside where she's happy to be.
Again, as the two fighters boxers broke away from the clinch, it was a short cuffing right hand by Marshall which got through. Long right cross over the top from Marshall. And then just using that footwork to great effect. And that is one of the strong suits of her boxing. She's moving up to this 75 kilogram weight class. Hasn't fully grown into it yet, she feels. But the twinkle toes that she possesses from her lighter days, her lighter weight class, is just beginning to put to good effect now, as she landed with a corking left hook, half uppercut at close quarters.
Yeah, this is in contrast. Volnova, in contrast, has come down from 81 and 81 plus. Where at 81 kilograms, she won a silver medal in the World Championships in 2010. So Volnova, used to being inside here, she is a shorter boxer, but Savannah Marshall is starting to use her range now, checking off with that hook, throwing simple combinations.
But as the bell sounds, Marshall finds herself trailing by two. It is 8 points to 10 in favor of Volnova. Marshall is going to have it all to do if the number one seed is to progress through to the semi-finals.
I have to say, Ron, that there was a wave of boos echoing here from the crowd who don't seem to agree with that score after the third round. And I'm inclined to agree, I think, Ron, with the crowd. I thought Savannah Marshall...
Let the jab go with the back end. Don't fall in. You fall in, it'll
just
get
listening
messy.
To the corner.
You'll get messy. You'll get a distance right with the jab. Right? Come on your feet. Let's go. Let's go.
As we enter the fourth and final round of this women's 75-kilogram middleweight bout, the boxer wearing red, representing Great Britain, the world champion and number one seed here in the Olympic boxing tournament, is receiving a spirited ovation from the capacity crowd on hand here at the XL Arena, because she is trailing by two to Kazakhstan's Marina Volnova, wearing blue, trailing for the first time in the contest at the completion of the third round. It was tied at 4 points apiece after one, 7 points apiece after two rounds of boxing. And then after a third round, she's trailing by two. And the number one seed and reigning world champion is going to have to produce a quite impressive performance to overturn a 2-point deficit, to score without reply in what is surely one of the biggest challenges of her amateur boxing career. She lands with a short arcing left hook at close quarters, but she has it all to do as we approach a halfway stage of this third, fourth and final round.
Great rear hand left hook there by Marshall. Ignites the crowd as they support her, landing her shots. Volnova intent to spoil on the inside, preventing Marshall from throwing and landing her successful shots.
The strategy of Volnova absolutely clear. She's the shorter of the two boxers. She's coming down from 81 kilograms. Marshall is moving up from 69. So the edge advantage in movement and mobility would suspect is Marshall, but Volnova content to get to close quarters. Oh, that is a good left hand as Volnova went in, but and can prevent Marshall from working away. We're seeing it time and time. A minute and a half has gone, and Volnova is spoiling effectively to prevent Marshall from working, holding around the waist, holding around the back of the neck. And we see a really stern admonishment. There are less than 30 seconds to go. Volnova will be keen not to get a public warning, but back at range, Marshall getting on her boxing, trying to score with her own effective shots. Trailing by two coming to this fourth and final round. These closing 10 seconds are going to be absolutely crucial in determining the outcome of this contest and the fate of the number one seed and reigning world champion. The decibel level rises here at the XL Arena at the conclusion of four pulsating two-minute rounds of boxing, and the decision will hang in the balance. It will be determined by the five judges seated ringside, and which way will it go? Marshall trailed by two going into that fourth and final round. She scored effectively with some really good singles. Volnova was content to spoil for the majority of the round. It's going to be decided by the five judges.
It was the right tactics there by Volnova. She had to spoil to protect the lead that she had. She scored a good right hand there as Savannah Marshall came in. But I think the Marshall in that round scored the cleaner, the more eye-catching shots, as she has done, I believe, for most of the bout.
Well, anxious moments these now for both of the boxers. The official verdict is about to be handed to the public address announcer. And he will announce which one of these is going through to the medal stages.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 16 points to 12 in the blue corner, representing Kazakhstan, Marina Volnova.
We have an upset here in the women's 75 kilogram middleweight division, because Great Britain's Savannah Marshall, the reigning world champion and number one seed in the Olympic boxing tournament, has been eliminated. She loses on points by a score of 16 to 12, and it's Marina Volnova from Kazakhstan who progresses through to guarantee her place on the medal podium. So Savannah Marshall's Olympic experience has been just one contest long. She was given a bye by virtue of that number one seeding, but she has been outpointed by an effective performance from the boxer from Kazakhstan. Marina Volnova progresses through to the semi-finals. She'll stand atop the Olympic medal podium, where Savannah Marshall, her Olympic experience begins and ends here at the quarterfinal stage.
Well, we've said before, Ron, that byes don't always give you an advantage. In effect, you know, your boxers that have boxed have the momentum, whereas you wait around and you think about the bout, and it's not good for a boxer to be waiting around, and byes are really a disadvantage. But I thought Marshall there scored the more eye-catching shots, the cleaner shots, and the crowd seemed to agree, weren't very happy with that final decision.
The referee is Mahadir Jamani Yazov from Uzbekistan. The boxers represent Sweden and the United States of America, so give them a big cheer as they enter the ring.
The woman wearing red, representing Sweden, ahead of her second bout here at the Olympic Games in London 2012, is one of the most decorated women amateur boxers of all time. A two-time world champion at 75 kilograms in the middleweight division. 2001, the first ever world championships in Scranton 11 years ago, and also in 2005. And her opponent is at the opposite end of the experience spectrum. It is a teenage phenom from Flint, Michigan, 17 years of age, Claressa Shields from the United States of America, approaching the ring for her Olympic debut.
Well, we've heard a huge amount, Ron, about Claressa Shields in the lead up to this Olympics. She's a little superstar in the USA, only 17 years old, as you say. She went into the World Championships earlier on this year undefeated, but succumbed to Great Britain's Savannah Marshall in the second preliminary round.
In the red corner, representing Sweden, the two-time former world champion, Anna Laurell. And in the blue corner, representing the United States of America, Claressa Seconds out. Round one.
The opening bell sounds in this women's 75 kilogram middleweight bout between the boxer wearing red, representing Sweden. The tallest boxer in the competition at 6 feet tall is Anna Laurell, a former two-time world championship gold medalist at 75 kilograms, and her opponent is somebody just beginning her international senior career, 17-year-old teenage phenom from Flint, Michigan in the United States of America, Claressa Shields. Possesses terrific hand speed, does Shields. That is one of the hallmarks of her boxing. And she's just beginning her international senior career, entered the World Championships after taking gold at the Pan American Women's Championship. She was undefeated in international competition. Most of that did take place in North America. As she traveled for the first time, she came up short against Great Britain's Savannah Marshall to experience her first loss in the USA vest. But now here she is, competing on the Olympic stage. And the shorter boxer is on the front foot and the aggressor in this opening round.
Claressa Shields, just content, just to command the centre there, getting a feel for what Laurell has got. Laurell, in contrast, just trying to keep it at range. I'd pick her off with the jab and the check hook as Shields comes in.
So inside the final 30 seconds, it's a speculative foray to the body by Shields. Good left hook to finish that middle exchange, and then once more a long looping left catches Laurell. He had similar problems in her opening bout with the speed of her opponent. That was against the Australian Fisher Rasmussen yesterday. She made terrific adjustments in subsequent rounds. And one suspects she's going to have to find similar adjustments here as she's content to operate on the perimeter of the ring. And just snapped home a good left jab before that closing bell. But despite her aggression, Claressa Shields finds herself trailing by two. Let's listen in.
Landing with a strong jab, followed by a rear hand, cuffing rear hand. And again there with a 1-2 combination leading with a rear hand. I think Laurell scored her points in the early part of the round, and as Shields got into the flow, got into the momentum, we began to see what she's capable of.
Into the second round we go. It's scheduled for 4 2-minute rounds in the women's 75 kilogram middleweight division between the boxer wearing red, representing Sweden, 32 years of age, one of the most decorated and respected female amateur boxers of all time, Anna Laurell, two-time world championship gold medalist back at the inaugural championships. She just received a stiff left hand from Claressa Shields there. Three-time gold medalist in European championships as well, against an opponent just beginning her international career, but who possesses immense talent. Claressa Shields from the USA, just 17 years of age, and is the 2012 Pan American Women's Champion, having defeated Mary Spencer, Canada's legendary boxer, in the final.
Well, we heard the American coach there telling Shields to use the jab. I'm not sure that's going to be hugely effective against a taller, rangier boxer unless she doubles up the jab and follows it with a rear hand. I think what she's doing and what's coming off very effective is she throws to the body first, she gets inside that range, and then she can throw the shots to the head. This is what she needs to do more of. She needs to go to the body, then to the head.
Laurell remaining very composed in the face of the aggression being demonstrated by Shields. Shields got through with a good shot to the body. Again, rather untidy on the inside, and for the second time in the round, Laurell warned, who she scored with a good long right cross. Beautiful corkscrew uppercut underneath by Laurell, but then she takes a stiff shot in reply from Shields.
Short, sharp right hand there to end that sequence by Shields.
And now it's Laurell commanding centre ring. Shields content to use her lateral movement on the outside in an effort to draw Laurell in. So real cat and mouse strategy being employed now, as a hard right hand is dug into the body by Shields. And look at her work away with that right hand to Laurell's ribcage. Being warned for holding and hitting. Remember, the referee will only issue three commands in amateur boxing: stop, box and break, as Shields got through with a good right hand. Laurell rather untidy at close quarters. And as the bell sounds to end at round at number two, Shields has closed the deficit. It stood at 2 points, she's reduced it to one, but she's still trailed by 7-6 to Anna Laurell from Sweden after two completed rounds of boxing.
You see on the replay here, Laurell landing a jab, but that's followed up with Shields and a long looping rear hook. I'll tell you what, Ron, these punches from Shields are not light. They're not tippy-tappy punches. I think you know when you've been hit by this girl. Look at this hook, knocking Laurell off balance there.
Work behind that jab and that combination. Okay, you only got one. Get that back, okay? Go in there. Right there. Let's go. No cheap shots.
into the second half of this women's 75 kilogram middleweight contest we go between Anna Laurell, the former two-time world championship gold medalist, three-time European champion as well. She's wearing red, representing Sweden, being picked off by some hard singles now, and just listen to those shots thudding into the ribcage of Laurell from Claressa Shield, 17 years of age, from Flint, Michigan in the United States. What a right hand from Shields once more, whose hand speed is absolutely blazing here in the third round. Good shot to the body by Shields, followed up with a left hook upstairs. And when Laurell began boxing in 1997, Claressa Shields was just 2 years old. She started boxing when she was 11. She's landing more effective shots before the boxers fall into a clinch. She started boxing because of her dad. She was 9 years old when Claressa absorbed his passion for boxing. Good shot. But then Shields is warned about about the shot straying low. And so has absorbed her father's passion for boxing and competing here on the Olympic stage.
Yeah, Shields is getting the success here when she switches from the body to the head. And that left hook, devastating left hook, ending on that left hook is knocking Laurell off her balance.
So Laurell on the front foot now before going back to center ring and waiting for a response from Shields. Plenty of twitching and feinting taking place, just looking for one of those crucial openings. Good right uppercut from Laurell. And it's back at range once more. Terrific straight shots fired in by Laurell at range. And Laurell remaining incredibly composed in the face of this aggression and hard punching aggression from Shields, and just picks her off with a jab once more. So as the closing bell sounds to bring about an end to round number two, the round favors Shields with that marauding aggression. She has again reduced the deficit. It was 12 points apiece after three completed rounds of boxing.
Well, I think that immediately score reflects the bout.
Okay, you're swinging up there and you're missing. All right, I need you to continue to the right off the shoulders. Double the jab, right hand hook. Okay, come back up, right hand hook.
There we go. We hear the corner there saying you've got to double up the jab and throw the right hand. I agree. She also needs to throw the combinations head and body. She continues in that vein to throw those combinations as she did in that last round. We may well see Shields crown the victor.
As we move into the fourth and final round in the women's 75 kilogram weight class, this contest has been incredibly competitive between boxers at opposite ends of the experience spectrum. Anna Laurell representing Sweden wearing red, and her opponent is Claressa Shields, who scores with a hard right hand left hook combination. And it's been accurate punching like that that has seen her prevail in rounds two and three after losing the opening round by a score of 4-2. It is tied at 12 points apiece, so everything to box for between these two contestants. And it's the woman wearing red who is competing regardless of the outcome in her first and final Olympic Games. Anna Laurell is 32 years old and takes a thunderous left hook. Shields is hyped up and it brings about a standing count here in the fourth and final round.
What an astonishing hook that was. I'm not sure Laurell has collected her head entirely, although she's stalking opponent now on the front foot, suggesting that she did well to ride that punch.
Right hand to the body driven in, and then at close quarters it's Shields working away with the right hand. And having been tied at 12 points apiece, one suspects that the momentum is just with Shields as we enter the final 30 seconds of this fourth and final round. And Laurell, she will know that she's been tagged by a couple of clean punches and will be looking to land effectively by using that superior reach that she possesses. The tallest boxer in the tournament had been closed down effectively during the course of rounds two, three, and indeed four. And as we approach the final 15 seconds, Shields is the aggressor once more. landing effectively. And she could well have done enough. Remember, she brought about a standing count here in the fourth round. Laurell trying to work away at close quarters. But as the closing bell sounds, Claressa Shields is in absolutely no doubt that she has overturned the legendary figure in women's boxing, who is Anna Laurell, the two-time World Championship gold medalist, the three-time European champion. She took round one, did Laurell, but slowly, slowly, almost imperceptibly, Shields fought her way back with hard, accurate punching like that, and it was that left hook that brought about the only standing count of the contest.
Yeah, what a thrilling conclusion to that contest, Ron. And my goodness, you can see in that replay the power in that left hook of Claressa Shields. She raises her hands. She believes she did enough to do it, did enough to claim the win.
Both boxers raising their hands in anticipation of victory. That moment will be confirmed when the official verdict is announced to this capacity-filled crowd here at London's XL Arena.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 18 points to 14 in the blue corner, representing the United States of America, Claressa Shields.
Claressa Shields from Flint, Michigan, jumps for joy after being announced as the winner in the women's 75 kilogram weight class quarterfinal. She's guaranteed herself a place on the podium at the very start of her international career. It's a masterful performance. You see the way she eased her way back into the contest. After trailing by 2 points at the end of the first round, she won every single subsequent round, and to the victor the spoils. She'll have an Olympic medal guaranteed now that she has progressed through to the quarterfinals. Job, good job, well done, overcoming the immense ability and experience of Anna Laurell of Sweden.
Well, another upset there, Ron. We heard so much hype about this young lady from the USA, and by goodness, has she lived up to that reputation. What a fabulous display of boxing.
The third quarterfinal in the women's 75-kilogram competition are number one, Cuba, number two, Republic of Korea, number three, Hungary, number four, France, and number five, Turkey. The referee is Michael Gallagher from Ireland. The boxers in this penultimate bout of the session are both former world champions, so please give them a big welcome.
Approaching the ring for her Olympic debut is one of the best women boxers there has ever been in the amateur ranks. Canada's Mary Spencer, a three-time World Championship gold medalist. And her opponent, representing China, is Li Jinzi. Gold medalist in the World Championships in 2008. And this promises to be a really high-quality encounter between two skilled operators.
Yeah, I'm gonna say the word again, Ron, another living legend, Mary Spencer here. We very nearly didn't see her here at the Olympics as she was knocked out in the second preliminary round in the qualifying tournament, the World Championships earlier on this year, but she was offered a tripartite place, a wild card place. So delighted to see her here today.
Republic of China, the 2008 world champion, Jinzi Li.
seconds out. Round one.
The opening bell sounds in this women's 75 kilogram quarterfinal, the middleweight division, and what a contest we have in prospect between two of the best boxers in the business. Wearing red, representing Canada, boxing out of the orthodox stance, is Mary Spencer, a three-time World Championship gold medalist, making her Olympic debut, having received a bye during the preliminary round. And her opponent, from China, Li Jinzi, a World Championship gold medalist in 2008. And this promises to be an absolutely enthralling encounter between two of the best boxers in their weight class.
Yeah, Lee predictably starting on the back foot, just getting an idea about what Mary Spencer's got to offer. Both boxers just taking their time to try and suss each other out.
Spencer, 5 years senior to Lee, 27 years old as opposed to 22. Two tall boxers, Spencer listed at 5'11" and Lee stands around 5'9". But Lee possesses wonderful movement, and she demonstrated that to terrific effect yesterday. She takes a strong 1-2 from Mary Spencer. But in her opening bout, Li Jinzi boxed beautifully to prevail by a score of 19 points to 14 over Brazil's Roseli Feitosa.
Lee moving well here, although uncharacteristically, she just did just hold her feet a little longer than she should. She got caught by that 1-2 just a moment ago by Mary Spencer. But throws that check hook to get off the ropes.
Well, it's a bull rush forwards and tidy use of the feet, and it brings about a standing count.
I'm not sure about that, Ron. I think she just tripped over more than anything else. I'm not sure I saw many of those land, but, you know, it just gives her an opportunity to collect herself.
So approaching the closing bell of this opening round. It's going to be interesting to see how the score stands. 3 points to two in favor of Spencer. So a 1 point advantage for the boxer representing Canada at the conclusion of the first round.
Oh, a good left hook there as we see from Mary Spencer. She's running and punching. Well, maybe she did, I stand corrected. She did catch her with the backhand just on the end there. Final punch.
Well, here's the furry forwards again. Plenty of throwing, plenty of flailing.
Oh, no.
You see, it's a collision with the turnbuckle that causes the head to snap back. Perhaps that's all the referee could see, and so a standing count was administered.
Yeah, we can understand then why the referee gave that standing count. Very difficult for us to see. It took us two replays to find out what happened there. So again, no more points there, just an opportunity for Lee to collect herself at the end of that round.
So we move into the second round in this women's 75 kilogram weight class between the boxer wearing red, representing Canada, the three-time World Championship gold medalist, Mary Spencer. We had to endure an agonizing wait to see whether she'd be able to compete in this inaugural women's tournament here at the 2012 Olympic Games. Good right hook from Lee. And again, she's having real success with that shot to begin this second round. She was trailing by 1 point, and they saw the jab snake through the guard of Spencer as well. It was an agonizing wait for Spencer to see whether she would be selected as a wild card effectively after being knocked out of the World Championships to Anna Laurell of Sweden in the first preliminary round. That put her Olympic selection in jeopardy. But it's great to see one of the most medaled boxers in the sport competing here on the Olympic stage. It's been a bright start to the second round by Lee. 12 by one after the opening round.
We see Mary Spencer in the early part of this round just making a few mistakes, dropping that front hand, and Lee capitalizes on that straight away by throwing those arcing rear hooks, right hand hooks to the head. Ooh, 1-2, good 1-2 combination there. Rocking the head, and again, a rear hand by Lee, rocking the head back of Mary Spencer.
Penetrating the guard beautifully. Spencer's hands are up, but there is daylight in between them. And Lee is finding that with superb accuracy. Approaching the final 30 seconds of this second round. Good right uppercut on the inside from Lee as well. So not just success with straight shots, but wonderful punch variety. And now she's demonstrating the type of movement she exhibited yesterday in her opening round contest. And it appears to be very effective indeed. She trailed by one after one round of boxing. But she has put her punches together beautifully and allied them with some wonderful movement here in the second.
Yeah, Spencer, just not sure how to get around these sort of long looping shots. She keeps a nice high guard now. I think she's learned about that rear hook coming over the top. She's just not sure how to combat this speed.
And indeed, the dominant second round enjoyed by Lee is reflected on the scoreboard. After trailing by one, she has taken a 2-point advantage, so it's a 3-point turnaround. Lee now leads by a score of 7-5.
Yep, good. There's that rear hook that I thought she lost to tremendous effect in that round. Little chopping right hand there from Mary Spencer, but replied by three straight shots there by Lee. Snapping the head back once again of Mary Spencer. Here we go, 1-2. Oh, we can see the power behind those shots, and she covers up nicely. And again, the rear hand.
And then good use of the legs to avoid any potential reply. Wonderful movement being exhibited by Lee during round number two. So as we move into the second half of the bout, she's got her nose in front. So round three begins in this women's 75 kilogram middleweight bout that is scheduled for 4 2-minute rounds, and with the woman wearing red representing Canada, Mary Spencer, trailing by a score of 7-5 after the second round. She has come out in aggressive fashion to begin round number three.
Well, we see Lee here, happy to stand, happy to be on the front foot. Usually we see her dancing around the ropes. She seems confident here to stand on the front foot, stand in the center of the ring with Mary Spencer.
You see that movement being used, just reducing Spencer to swings which are missing by a distance, and in and out once more with beautiful boxing movement being exhibited by Lee. And then back on balance, changing the angles and getting through with snaking quick shots.
Great two-phase attack there, and landed with a fantastic rear hand.
Did take a jab in reply from Spencer on that occasion, did Lee? But her movement is posing Spencer with all types of trouble. And as you've already pointed out in previous contests, Lucy, this Spencer's Olympic debut, she was the recipient of a bye. I hesitate to say beneficiary, because she could well be adversely affected by not boxing on that opening day of the women's tournament. Lee got used to the atmosphere, got used to the crowd, got used to the ring. And just picking up where she left off yesterday. Whereas Spencer is having to create that momentum, overcome the inertia of not boxing on the opening day.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, most boxers would prefer not to have a bye, in actual fact, so that they can get that momentum. But Lee here, you can see, growing in confidence with every second that ticks by. Happy to switch the attack, head to body. Two-punch combination there. Just caught on the guard of Mary Spencer, but a wonderful rear hand hook to the body.
So the referee allowing the boxers to work away on the inside. You see Spencer nudging shots to the body. And the bell sounds to bring about an end. And it is still a 2-point round, after 2-point advantage enjoyed by Lee. It's been an even round, 3 points apiece, but Spencer needs more than that if she's to progress through to the semi-finals in the women's 75 kilogram division.
Yeah, here we see Lee with that rear hand jab combination landing quite obviously for the judges, although she catches a rear hand there herself from Mary Spencer. Confident corner there, it seems. In the blue corner.
So what can Spencer do to turn this around now? She had a good opening round, but what can she do to get herself back on terms and indeed in front in just 2 minutes of boxing?
Well, Spencer needs to do do what she does best, actually. She throws great combinations. She throws combinations to the head and to the body, but she needs to make sure she does it from the right place, not from the centre of the ring, where Lee is taking the advantage at range. Oh, my goodness. This is Lee getting a warning for holding.
Well, we asked, what can Spencer do to get herself back on terms and back in front automatically? It will be tied up at 10 points apiece before a meaningful shot has been landed, because that public warning, as Lee gets her head just trapped between the ropes, that public warning issued to Lee for holding is 2 points onto the score of Spencer.
Well, this has spurred Spencer on now. She knows that she will be even after that warning. And now she's doing what she needs to do, and that's throw the combinations from the head to the body when Lee is on the ropes.
Lee just penetrating the guard with a snaking left jab, and then a 1-2 combination delivered at terrific speed, followed by a right cross. All effective scoring blows. Spencer's holding her hands high, but Lee is finding the gaps with wonderful precision.
Spencer needs to keep that guard nice and tight.
Lee now getting onto the front foot, and again scoring with a good right cross. And that public warning that was issued to Lee, which would have put 2 points onto the score of Spencer, to erase that 2-point deficit that Lee enjoys, has really brought about a change in strategy. She's getting onto the front foot. She's scoring effectively. And now the referee allowing them to work away. You see Lee's left hand trapped on the inside, and then she pins Spencer in her own corner, in Lee's corner, in that blue corner, and just scored effectively. And then takes a cuffing right hand around the air and left uppercut on the inside from Spencer.
Well, that's certainly where Lee doesn't need to be. She doesn't need to be on the inside. Mary Spencer is fantastic working on the inside. Little short shots, little body shots, little uppercuts. Lee needs to keep it at range.
Just have to wonder if both of these boxers are beginning to feel the pace. You see the hands are low from Spencer, and Lee is looking to take full advantage, pinning her in the red corner and unloading with lefts and rights. And there's just 10 seconds to go in this contest, and these seconds could well be crucial in determining the outcome. Lee appears to be fresher, appears to be fitter, and is lasting the pace better. And look at the way she has finished the round. That could well be crucial in giving her the verdict. And indeed, their body language in that blue corner suggests that Lee has done enough. She led by two. Just get this into context. She led by two after three rounds of boxing. But immediately, as the fourth and final round began, she was given a public warning for holding. That means 2 points onto the score of the boxer in red, Mary Spencer. That would have tied it up at 10 apiece. But what a response that brought about from Lee representing China. Here's the moment she got that public warning, which put those crucial 2 points onto the score of her opponent.
Yeah, it brought the score back to parity in that final round. But I think Lee landed the more eye-catching, the cleaner shots, beg your pardon, on Mary Spencer towards the latter part of that round. I think Lee might just have clinched it.
It is going to be very interesting indeed. Public warning, hugely significant, and it brought about a tremendous response from Lee, who got onto the front foot and was able to find the gaps in Spencer's guard.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 17 points to 14 in the blue corner, representing the People's Republic of China, Jinzi Lee.
What a tremendous performance from Li Jinzi, the World Championship gold medalist in 2008. Has beaten the three-time World Championship gold medalist from Canada, Mary Spencer, competing in her first Olympic bout, having received a bye in the preliminary round. She exits the ring and indeed exits the tournament. But Lee boxed superbly and gets her arm deservedly raised in triumph.
Yeah, I think so. Thoroughly deserved win, although it was very close, of course, towards the end. And I think we see that really these byes aren't helping out the female boxers at all.
Ladies,
another
gentlemen,
boxer going out after a bye.
Quarterfinal in the women's 75 kilogram competition are number one, Vietnam, number two, Greece, number three, Argentina, number four, the United States of America, and number five, Morocco. The referee is Mick Batsy from Great Britain.
It's Nigeria versus the Russian Federation in our final bout of this session. And here come the boxers.
En route to the Olympic boxing ring for the second time, wearing red, representing Nigeria, it is all smiles from Edith Ogoke, who produced an absolutely stunning upset yesterday to eliminate the reigning world silver medalist, and how she is enjoying her moment on the Olympic stage. Making her way toward the boxing ring for her Olympic debut after receiving a bye yesterday, the number two seed in the tournament. Nadezda Torlopova, 33 years of age, representing Russia, and the gold medalist from 2010 in the 75 kilogram weight class. Reigning bronze medalist from 2012, losing to the ultimate champion Savannah Marshall at the semi-final stage in China a few months ago. And again, she has the edge in experience, but how will she react after receiving that bye in her opening bout?
In the red corner, representing Nigeria, Edith Ogoke. And in the blue corner, representing the Russian Federation, Nadezda Torlopova.
The opening bell sounds in this women's quarterfinal in the 75 kilogram middleweight division between the boxer wearing red, representing Nigeria, Edith Ogoke, and her opponent wearing blue, the number two seed in the competition, the reigning bronze medalist, who just took a stiff right hand from Ogoke, operating out of that southpaw stance, is Nadezda Torlopova, representing Russia.
Well, Ogoke received a tremendous reaction from the audience in her opening bout of this Olympic competition. Torlopova, as you have said, Ron, received the bye and so has not yet boxed in this competition. We've seen really that this has been a bit of a disadvantage. So can she overcome this adversity and demonstrate her vast experience against Ogoke in this bout?
33 years of age is Torlopova, so this will be her last Olympic experience, regardless of the outcome, because the World Boxing Governing Body, IEBA, have an upper age limit of 34 in operation. She takes a stiff left hand from Ogoke as she tries to work her way inside. You see the contrast in height and reach, no doubt about the boxer who has the greater international pedigree, but again, that was the case yesterday when Ogoke produced a stunning upset as she lands with a strong left cross. She produced a stunning upset against the reigning silver medalist from the World Championships, Elena Vistropova. But Ogoke proved to be no respecter of reputations, came out and applied pressure from the opening bell. She lands a strong left cross to the sternum of Torlopova.
Torlopova just keeping it long here, trying not to get in the way. She will know, she will have seen Ogoke box in her opening bout. She doesn't want to get anywhere near those swinging hooks.
So as the bell sounds to bring about an end to round number one, it is tied at 3 points apiece. Let's take a listen into the Nigerian corner. The man giving the instructions, who is the coach of the Nigerian team, is Kevin Smith, man who was a coach of a young man who featured in an Olympic boxing documentary, Jazza Dickens and Anthony Fowler as well, up in Liverpool. The Nigerian team have been based up in Bradford in preparation for this Olympic tournament. And whatever they've been doing up there is paying dividends because she has come into this tournament and sprung one of the biggest upsets of the entire Olympic competition.
She absolutely has, Ron. We can see she has no fear. She doesn't care who she gets in with. She had the confidence in one of her media interviews. She said, I don't care who I get in with. I've got no respect of reputations. I'm going to go in there, I'm going to do my thing, and I'm going to win.
So she's trying to take the bout to her opponent in blue, representing Russia, Nadezda Torlopova, is Edith Ogoke of Nigeria. That's the boxer in red, operating out of the southpaw stance. Just one international tournament prior to the Olympic Games, and that was the World Championships in China. The two boxers met at that stage, the two boxers in the ring met at that stage. And it was a comprehensive victory for Torlopova, but this an entirely different tournament, the Olympic stage. And of course, Ogoke will be buoyed by that terrific upset victory she engineered yesterday. So we'll be trying to ride that wave of momentum against an opponent who's competing for the first time, having received a bye as the number two seed.
Ogokeno's sitting so beautifully just on the edge of range. Boxing's all about small distances, all about half inches, and she's sitting just nicely off that range of Torlopova, making it very difficult for the Russian to get inside, although she does, just as I say that, she lands a tremendous backhand.
Good right hand, but then an instant right hand riposte from Torlopova, so that was an exchange. Remember, it was tied at 3 points apiece entering this second round. And as you approach the closing second, it's a good left cross to the sternum. And Torlopova just appears to be a little bit slow with her feet and with her hands as she takes another right hand, knocks Ogoke off balance. But she has done enough to engineer a 6 point lead after a score that was tied at 3 points apiece at the end of the first round. She now leads by a scoreline of 10-4.
Yeah, I'm afraid I didn't see that, Ron. I think a hugely surprising score, and actually the crowd seemed to agree. We saw Torlopova there landing a strong shot, and again there with the rear hand. But for me, I think throughout the majority of that round, Ogoke landed some the more eye-catching shots.
7-1, the second round has been scored in favour of Torlopova.
I don't quite know what the judges saw there. Perhaps they saw something we didn't.
So we move into the second half of this women's 75 kilogram middleweight bout between the boxer wearing red, operating out of the southpaw stance, Edith Ogoke from Nigeria, and her opponent from Russia, wearing blue, the tournament number two seed and reigning world bronze medalist. Gold medalist from the World Championships 2 years ago in Barbados at plus 81 kilograms, that is Nadezda Torlopova. So coming down into the weight class, this Torlopova, you can see she's a towering figure of a boxer. 33 years of age, and then receives a cuffing, looping shot, which brings about a strong response. And a knockdown scored with the right hand for the Russian number two seed.
Three strong rear hands there from the Russian. I'm not surprised Ogoke ended up on the canvas.
Found her back to the ropes with nowhere to go except downwards. And that's spurring Torlopova on. She's got attempting to pin Ogoke in the blue corner, but Ogoke flailing with both left and rights in an effort to box her way out of there.
She was flailing in that corner though, Ron, but she landed with those shots. It just depends whether the judges are calling them slaps occasionally. Perhaps they could be on the inside of the glove. Subjective opinion, but
good left jab sneaking through from Torlopova, and again as we approach the final 30 seconds. And all of a sudden now, Torlopova beginning to employ that advantage in height and reach and measure her opponent wonderfully.
He catches one on the way in there, though, Ron. Is this where we see the experience showing through? This will be a test of endurance towards the latter half of this bout.
So at the end of the third round, the lead, which was 6 at the end of round number 2, now stands at 8. It is 14 points to 6 in Torlopova's favour at the end of the third round.
Yeah, Torlopova won that round 4 points to 2, and I agree, on this occasion, Torlopova did land some tremendous straight shots there, which resulted in a Ogoke there visiting the canvas temporarily. Look at that shot, tremendous backhand, and again. Goodness me, we see the power in those slow motion replays. You absolutely deserve to win that round, Torlopova.
As we move into the fourth and final round of this women's 75 kilogram middleweight quarterfinal, it is the boxer wearing blue representing Russia, the number 2 seed, Nadezda Torlopova, who has inserted her dominance steadily as this contest has progressed. And she has begun this fourth and final round in similar vein, scoring effectively with long lefts and rights to repel the onrushing advances of Nigeria's Edith Ogoke wearing red. Boxing out of the southpaw stance, looping right-hand lead, and again, it's difficult to discern whether that will be deemed a scoring blow or a slap. Remember, in order for it to be registered as a legitimate scoring blow, it should be landed with the knuckle part of the glove, as Torlopova just touches home a left jab and then gets on the front foot once more.
Yeah, she's taking command now of this bout, Torlopova. As you said, Ron, just measuring Ogoke with that jab and following it with a straight cross.
Good exchange of shots. It was a right hand from Ogoke that had the final word, but then look at the contrast in the delivery of these punches. It's looping roundhouse blows being fired and occasionally landed by Ogoke, whereas Torlopova is having tremendous success with straight punches down the middle. She's being forced on her bike by Ogoke, and why wouldn't she, because she had an 8-point advantage coming into this final round. But now the crowd beginning to really get behind the underdog, the woman who has less international experience than the gold world champion from 2010 and two-time European gold medalist as well, including Rotterdam last year, and the crowd really cheering her on.
Well, this is dangerous in the latter part of this round. Torlopova can't afford to take one of Edith Ogoke's strong shots. She's got to stay disciplined right to the end. Ogoke quite capable of landing. Strong shot, but Torlopova has survived.
And it's a wonderful reception that Nigeria's Edith Ogoke is receiving here in the XL Arena in London's Docklands. She sprung perhaps one of the biggest surprises of the entire Olympic boxing tournament yesterday when she eliminated the reigning silver medalist. Hug of consolation and quite possibly congratulations from her coach Kevin Smith, given what she's achieved here at London 2012. But there can be no doubt about the victor in this quarterfinal. It is Nadezda Torlopova, the number 2 seed, making her Olympic debut, who boxed incredibly well indeed as the tournament progressed to assert her dominance. And she should have done enough to progress through to the final four. So the reigning European champion and world champion from 2 years ago, Nadezda Torlopova, makes it through to the final four. But listen to the wonderful reception that Edith Ogoke is receiving as she leaves the boxing ring and indeed leaves the Olympic tournament. There's confirmation as to how Torlopova slowly asserted her dominance after a tied opening round. But Edith Ogoke will remember her Olympic experience forever. She produced the upset, perhaps, of the tournament, certainly of the women's tournament, by eliminating the reigning silver medalist with a really intelligent, aggressive display of pressure power punching. But her Olympic experience comes to an end here at the quarterfinal stage. But it's one she will remember forever.